Okay, so the next method is assumed mean method. Now in assumed mean method, what are the steps that we are supposed to follow to calculate assumed mean method standard deviation? Let's see that. We get mean in fraction. Okay, so once we get mean in fraction, such circumstances we can use assumed mean as basis of calculating standard deviation. Now when you're getting fraction when you're calculating the mean, sometimes these point decimal points can vary a lot. Okay, so such circumstances we can use assumed mean. Why we have to use assumed mean? Because when we go back to the calculation here, if you see, you have got the mean directly as 44. Okay, so you have got the mean directly as 44. So it was easy for you to subtract x minus 44. That is the mean which we found out here. But the same thing cannot happen everywhere. If you see the next exercise problem, you are getting 0.33, right? So to find out the difference here, you will get points. Again, when you square, you will get points. So instead of that, we are going to use the assumed mean method where we will be calculating standard deviation by taking assumed mean. Okay, let's see how to calculate this. Step one. Select a representative value as assumed mean. So we have solved enough assumed mean problems in the central tendency chapter. So out of the data which we have, we are going to take one number as the assumed mean. No matter which number you take, you will get the same answer throughout. Okay, so that is the assumed mean. Next, step two, determine the deviations for each value from A and name it as D. Okay, so we are taking deviations. Deviations, as usual, formula will be X minus your assumed mean or midpoint minus assumed mean. So that assumed mean is denoted as A, and the whatever deviations we take, we write it as D. When you add all the deviations, it is known as sigma D, that is summation of D. After finding this, the next step is to square the deviations. When you square the deviations, it is called as d square. And when you add all of the numbers under the square deviations, it is called sigma or summation of d square. Once we find this out, we are supposed to use the formula given below. That is, standard deviation is equal to, okay, this symbol is called as sigma, which is a denotation for standard deviation. Standard deviation is equal to root of sigma d square, which we have calculated here, divided by n minus sigma d by n. So if sigma d we have found out here in step 2, sigma d by n whole square. Okay, be careful with the brackets here. So it is for the whole sigma d by n. Many of them will take the brackets only for this part sometimes. That is not the right answer, or that when you calculate, you don't get the right answer. Please take the brackets for the whole of sigma d divided by n and then write the square. Okay, there are a lot of confused people, students who get confused with this formula in particular. So be very careful. Now let's go on and understand this using a problem. Now here, this is the first problem. Again, we are solving individual series under assumed mean. So calculate the standard deviation from the following data. And you have so much of data, observed data given here. 50, 98, 103, 76, 5, 39 and 55. So this is the data that we have. Now out of this data, I am going to take one data, which is the any one data out of the runs that they have given. So first thing what we will do is we will arrange this individual observation into ascending order, starting from the smallest number. If you see, the smallest number is 5, then you have 39, then you have 50, 55, 76, then we have 98, and then 103. So that is what I've written here in the table. So we are starting from the smallest number and ending at the biggest number, that is 103. Now out of this data, I have to take one data, which, or one number, where I can say it as assumed mean. So out of these data, let us take 50 as assumed mean. Okay, there is no rule I have to take 50 only. You can take 55, you can take 103 also. You will still end up with the same answer. But why 50? Because it is easy for us to calculate when it is a whole number like this. Instead of 3 or you have 6, 8, when we square, the numbers might become too big. So I'm just taking 50, which is an easy number for us to calculate. So here we are going with 50 assumed mean. See, to find out why assumed mean, you will have to calculate mean first. Once you calculate mean, then you will be able to find out the actual value. So here, if you see in the previous problem, the first problem we did, you had a whole number for arithmetic mean. So it was easy for us to find out the deviations, and then we squared it. It was easy for us to find the whole numbers. But when it comes to assumed mean method, we are going to calculate or we are going to assume the mean here first. Why we are assuming? Because if you take any other number or calculate the normal mean, you will get lot of decimal points. When you get decimal points, let's take for example, your mean is, mean is equal to somewhere around 48.5987 something you're getting. This is example. Now in such scenario, what will happen? You are supposed to find the deviations. So D is equal to X minus 48.5987. So imagine how many points you have to write on every deviation that you calculate. So the problem will become too tedious, first thing. And the next thing is you will start getting confused. Okay, you will not be able to find the squares here. Again, if you get 45.789 into 45.789. So you will again get point here. Since the numbers will keep multiplying too much, that is why we are saying instead of taking the mean, okay, instead of taking the mean in points, let us assume a mean out of the data that is given and easily calculate standard deviation. Okay, I hope that that has cleared the doubt. Anybody still has doubt why, how to differentiate? Okay, let's continue with this problem. Now here we have assumed, we have taken assumed mean as 50 directly. Now once you have taken assumed mean as 50 directly, I am going to find the deviation. So if you see here, I have written it as assumed mean is equal to 50. Since it is an individual series, we don't calculate further. If it was any other series, we will take this and put the assumed mean formula and calculate. So since it's an individual series, we don't calculate too many things. We just consider one of the number to be mean and we go on and calculate the standard deviation. So after this, we have to calculate the deviations. Deviations, that is nothing but D is equal to, okay? So is equal to is missing here. D is equal to X minus 50. So 50 is our assumed mean. 50 is our assumed mean. So X is equal to, D is equal to X minus 50. So 5 minus 50 is 45 minus 45. Here we have to make note of the signs, plus or minus. Both the signs we have to consider. Then 39 minus 50 is 11. 50 minus 50 is 0. 55 minus 50 is 5. 76 minus 50 is 26. 98 minus 50 is 48. 103 minus 50 is 52. So only two numbers are negative. Rest of the numbers are positive in nature. So once you add all of these numbers up, okay, all the numbers we are adding and we get 76. So start from minus 45, minus 11, 0, 5, 26, 48, 52. So when you add up all these, you get 76 as sigma D. This is kept one side. Now let us go on and square these deviations. Okay, we found out d. All these are values of d. Now let us go on and square them. Squaring the deviations, what do we get? 45 square. 45 into 45 will give you 2025. 11 square is 121. 0 square is again 0. 5 square is 25. 26 square is 676. 48 square is 2304. 52 square is 2809. So you have to multiply these numbers with the same number once again. So minus, again minus, into minus 11, like this. You're supposed to multiply the same numbers to get these answers. So once you multiply all these numbers, you are supposed to add the numbers. So which are the numbers you'll be adding? The numbers that you'll be adding are d square, which you have found out. So once you add up all these numbers, you get the value of sigma or summation of d square. Sorry, this is some summation of d square, not x square. Okay, summation of d square. So summation of d square is 7960. Okay, so we have got summation d square is equal to 7960. So once we understand and find out all these values, the next step is only to apply the formula. So did you all understand the table first? Can you please leave it in chat? Did everybody understand the table? How to solve? Okay, that's nice. So everybody understood this table. Now let's go on and apply the formula to find out the standard deviation. Now, assumed mean here, which we already assumed it as to be 50, the value is 50, and then we went on to do the calculations. So formula for assumed mean is formula for standard deviation is sigma is equal to root of summation of d square by n minus summation d by n whole square. Okay, so here summation d square. Okay, summation d square. Let's see what have we found out in the table. Now summation d square, which we found out, was this. Okay, so I told this is d square. Okay, summation d square is 7960. So let's see what is that. What have we taken here? Summation d square is 7960 divided by n. Divided by n is how many number of data you have. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So n is equal to 7. 7960 divided by 7 minus sigma d or summation d. So what did we find? Summation d is 76. So summation d 76 divided by 7. Whole square. Be very careful here. It is whole square, which means you are first supposed to, you are expected to do the division first here, 76 by 7, and then square the number whatever you get. Okay, so I'm repeating it again. 7960 is sigma or summation of d square divided by n is the number of data that we had, minus sigma d or summation d by n. Summation d is 76 divided by n is the same 7 again. Whole square, which means first you have to divide 76 by 7 and then only square it up. Understood? I hope everybody understood so much. Now let's go for the next step. Next step is what they have done here is 7960 by 7 is the value which you get, that is 1137.14. Okay, 7960 divided by 7, you will directly get 1137.4. Now for the next one, 76 divided by 7 is 10.85. Okay, 76 divided by 7 is 10.85. When I multiply this 10.85 again, okay, when I multiply this 10.85 again, so in that scenario, I will get 117.87. So this value whatever is given here, 117.87, is the total value after squaring it. I'm going to repeat this part again. Be very careful because many of them does mistake in this part, especially in examinations. So 76.7, only this division, you get 10.85. Sorry, I'll just write it in the box here. So here you get 10.85. Now, what we are supposed to do, you get more decimals, 10.85714 and so on. Okay, that will be the decimals. Now, when you multiply whatever answer you get, again with 10.85, take at least 4 to 5 decimals, that is 85714. If you multiply both of them, then your answer is going to be 117.87. Okay. 87754 something you get, okay? Somewhere around this. So, this 117.84, this is the answer after I divide and square the complete variable here. Okay, now the next step. Now we are expected to subtract these two numbers, that is 1137.14 minus 117.87. So once I subtract these two numbers, I'm going to get root of, square root will remain as it is. So I'm going to get root of 1019.27. So 1019.27, if I take the square root, the standard deviation value is 31.926. Okay, so this is the final answer of standard deviation, which is 31.926. I'll just revise the whole problem once again for you to understand it better. So let's see. So we started with the assumed mean method. Here we have to consider one value as assumed mean. Then we have to find the deviations from the x values that is given to us and sum it up, that is called summation d. Then we have to square this d and add it up, that is called summation d square. Then you have to find out the standard deviation using this formula, that is square root of sigma d square by n minus sigma d by n whole square. So we went on to see the first problem with the data with 7 numbers in hand. So we arranged the data in ascending order in the table. So if you see from the smallest number to the largest number, it is arranged in the ascending order. Then we calculated the deviations, that is d is equal to x minus 50. So from where did we get 50? 50 is the assumed mean which we assumed from this data. So from this data we have assumed 50 as the assumed mean. So we have found out the deviations x minus 50. Once you find all the deviations, add everything up, that is called as summation d, which is equal to 76. Okay, the total of d is summation d 76. Then we found the squares of d, that is deviations, and named it as d square. When you add up all these numbers, it is known as summation d square. Okay, this is known as summation d square, which is 7960. Now, after finding all this, we went on to solve using the formula. So assumed mean, which we have already calculated or which we have already assumed, is 50. Then to find standard deviation, just apply the formula. Root of, square root of sigma d square. Sigma d square value 7960 divided by n, 7, minus sigma d is 76 divided by n, which is 7, whole square. I told, please be very careful with these squares and the brackets. Now, first you are supposed to divide these two, 7960 by 7, which will give you an answer of 1137.14. And this whole expression, including square, that gives you a value of 117.83. Be careful. First, you're supposed to divide 76 by 7 and then multiply the same number or then square the result, whatever you get. So your total standard deviation value is 31.926. Okay, so this is how we solve the assumed mean method. Hope everybody understood. If you have any doubt, you can leave it in chat so I can answer your question. Everybody understood? Nice. So I think we can go to the next question then. So next question is the next method we are supposed to learn. Thank you, students. Thank you for understanding. So next question is, we are supposed to learn the next method. So first, we learned the computation of standard deviation for individual series. In individual series, we have two methods, actual mean method, assumed mean method. In actual mean, we will calculate the normal arithmetic mean where we get the whole number and then we find out the standard deviation. In assumed mean method, if we get your arithmetic mean to be point, then we use assumed mean method. So in that case, we will assume a number as a mean and we will solve the standard deviation. Now, going on to the next type of series, that is discrete series and continuous series. So let's understand what are the methods we have under these. Now, these methods are very, very important. You can expect 6 marks and 14 marks question from standard deviation problems. Okay, discrete and continuous series. Now, let's understand this. The standard deviation of grouped data can be calculated by applying following methods. So they have 3 methods to follow. So let's see which are the 3 methods. First is actual mean method, like individual series. Even under discrete series, you have actual mean method. Then you have assumed mean method and you have step deviation method. So if you remember, these are the same methods which you will find under arithmetic mean. Okay, so the same 3 methods. Normal arithmetic mean when you calculate, then you have assumed mean, and then you have step deviation method. So the similar types of methods are also given here. So first, we will only understand the actual mean method and we will solve problems in this. Then we will go on to the further methods. Okay. So the first method is actual mean method. In actual mean method, what are the steps? Calculate the actual mean. Calculate actual mean is nothing but you will find out the arithmetic mean using the formula sigma fx. You will have frequency here because it's a discrete and continuous series. So sigma fx by n, or actual mean will be the other part is, if you have a deviation, then you will take sigma fd, right? So sigma fx by n, you will use the formula to find the arithmetic mean. Now, after finding arithmetic mean, next step, find x is equal to x minus x bar. So this is something like a deviation. So we will find x minus x bar. Once we find this x bar here, we will use this x bar to find out x minus x bar and name it as x again in discrete series. But in continuous series, we will find out midpoint. So we have to take the midpoint minus x bar. So this, I think everyone are well known of how to calculate this. Now after that, step 3. Now for step 3, find the square of x. So what is x? The difference that you have found here, x minus x bar or midpoint minus x bar. You have to find the square of x and that is called as x square. For all the values, we give a name called x square. After that, the next step, that is step 4, you will have to find out fx square. That is, this x square, whatever you have found out, multiply that with the frequency given in the problem. So once you find the, multiply the frequency given in the problem with the x square, you will get something called as summation fx square. Okay, summation fx square is given directly. Now, then we will be using this formula, that is, sigma is equal to root of x square by n. Okay, so here you will have an f added to this because it's a frequency. So fx square by n, where x is equal to x minus x bar, or m, this is in a discrete series and this is in continuous series, midpoint in continuous series. So this is your first method. Let's go on and solve one problem under this actual mean method. So you'll be able to understand it better. So this is the problem. Once the class is done, these notes will be forwarded in the WhatsApp group for you to copy down and understand. Okay, so this is the first problem. We are supposed to calculate standard deviation from the following data. And as you see the data, you will be able to recognize it to be discrete series. How do you know that? You have an x and f given. So normal frequency and x data is given. So we have this data. Now let's copy down this data into a table for solution. So that is computation of standard deviation will be heading. Every problem heading for the problem is compulsory. Okay, so heading problem heading for the problem is compulsory again. So you will have to make sure that the problem is there again. Now let's continue. So we took all the data of x here and we copied that down, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That is copied here. And the frequencies, whichever were there, that is also considered. That is going to be 3, 9, 11, 14, 12, 7, and 4. Okay, so that is the complete data from the question has been copied down. After this, we are supposed to find the actual mean. Actual mean is nothing but the arithmetic mean which we always find. That will be sigma fx by n. So when you find sigma fx by n, you have to first multiply f into x. So let's multiply f into x. That is 3 into 3, 4 into 9, 5 into 11, 6 into 14, 7 into 12, 8 into 7, and 9 into 4. So we are multiplying these two columns here completely. And once you multiply these two columns, you're going to find the values of fx. Okay. So we multiplied all the columns and we found the values of fx. So the total of this column is going to give you the values of, the total of this column is going to give you the values of f into x, that is 360. So summation fx will be 360. So this is the total value that we have got. Now next, after that, now let's go on and solve the arithmetic mean. Now arithmetic mean formula is very simple. That is sigma fx divided by n. Now n, how do we find in the discrete series? Is we add up all the formula, all the f values. Then we will get the total of n. So total of n is 60. So we'll just put all these numbers here. So 360 is taken from here and 60 with the total of n. So 360 by 60, you will get 6 as x bar. Now once you have got x bar or the mean value, now we just have to consider the next step, that is the calculation of deviations. Now x is equal to, this is equal to, here they give the brackets. So always understand this is x is equal to, x is equal to x minus x bar. So this is x is equal to x minus x bar. So x bar, we already found it to be 6. So that will be x is equal to x minus 6. Now x minus 6, if you find out, x is here. Okay, you have to consider this values. So when x is here, it is 3 minus 6 minus 3. Again, you have to consider the signs. Only in mean deviation, you have to ignore the signs. In standard deviation, we have to consider the signs. So minus 3, minus 2. 4 minus 6 is minus 2. 5 minus 6 is minus 1. 6 minus 6 is 0. 7 minus 6 is 1. 8 minus 6 is 2. 9 minus 6 is 3. So this is the value of x that we found out. That is x minus x bar. Now once you find all these values, now we are supposed to square them. So how do you square them? Multiply the same number again. So minus 3 into minus 3 is plus 9. Minus 2 into minus 2 is plus 4. Minus 1 into minus 1 is plus 1. 0 into 0. 1 into 1. 2 into 2. 3 into 3. So that will be the values. That will give you the values of x square. Once you have the values of x square, now what you can do is, you will have to multiply again. This x square has to be multiplied with one more column. That is your frequency. Okay, so that is here. The frequency column is here. Now multiply frequency into x square. That is 3 into 9, which is 27. 9 into 4, 36. 11 into 1, 14 into 0. 12 into 1, 7 into 4. 4 into 9. So you're supposed to multiply these two columns, that is f and x square, where you get f into x square. Now, once you multiply this and now add all the values of fx square, you get the total as 150. Okay, so sigma fx square is equal to 150. Now, that completes your table. Okay, so this is only the calculation of table. So what did we do throughout the table is we copied down x and f from the question, and then we multiplied x into f to find the actual mean or the arithmetic mean. Once we found out the arithmetic mean, we went on to calculate the deviations, that is x minus x bar. So after calculating x minus x bar, we squared the deviations or x, whatever we got. And then we again multiplied x square with the frequencies given in the problem to find fx square. Okay, so did everyone understand this table alone? Do you have any doubts in the table? Okay, so everybody understood the table. That's nice. So let's go on and solve or complete this part of the calculation, that is the formula. So we are only now left out with the formula part. Now, if you see the formula here, we already solved x bar to find out the deviations here. Now, apply the standard deviation formula. Standard deviation formula is root of sigma fx square divided by n. Okay, root of square root of sigma fx square divided by n. So sigma fx square we already found out, which is to be 150. Okay, we already found out the sigma fx square to be 150. We'll take that 150 here, divided by n. N is 60. That is the total of your frequency. So n is 60, which is equal to square root of 150 divided by 60 will give you an answer of 2.5. When you divide these two numbers, you get 2.5. So the next simplification is square root of 2.5. The standard deviation value for this particular problem that is given to us is 1.581. Okay, 1.581 is our standard deviation. I hope the calculation is also clear. So this is a discrete series problem. So the formula for the discrete series is sigma fx square, the standard deviation formula, ST. Okay, that is sigma fx square divided by n. Okay, so we have one more problem under continuous series. Let's just look at that. That is also a very easy problem. So the next problem is your continuous series. You can see the data with class intervals 10 to 20, 20 to 30, and the frequencies given. So there is a table here. For every class interval, we have to find out the midpoint. Okay, that is always implied that you're supposed to calculate the midpoint. How do you calculate midpoint? Take the lower limit of the class interval, add to the upper limit of the class interval, and divide that by 2. So 10 plus 20 by 2 is 15, 20 plus 30 by 2 is 25. Likewise, you have to calculate the midpoint. Now, once you calculate the midpoint, multiply frequency into midpoint. So FM, why are we doing this? We are doing this to find out the actual mean. So multiply both of these columns, F into M. So once you multiply that, you get sigma fm to be 1140. And if you add up frequency, you get the total of 30. Now let's find out the x bar or mean. So the formula for this is x bar is equal to summation of fm by n. It's not fx. Okay, it is fm divided by n, which is equal to 1140 divided by 30. So your x bar is 38. Okay, once you find out the actual mean, again same steps, x is equal to x minus x bar. Okay, so this is x minus x bar. X bar is 38. calculate the deviations. But here, be careful. You are not supposed to take x or the class interval. This is supposed to be m. Okay, this is supposed to be m. X means you are supposed to take the midpoints. So 15 minus 38, 25 minus 38, that is minus 13, 35 minus 38 is minus 3, 45 minus 38 is 7. Likewise, you will calculate. So take the numbers from midpoint and not from the class interval. Next, after this, the next step for you to calculate is squaring these numbers. Okay, square them. 20 minus 23 into minus 23, minus 13 into minus 13. So find the squares. After finding the square, multiply these squares with the frequency. Okay, x square into frequency. This column and this column has to be multiplied. So once you multiply these two columns, you're gonna get fx square. After finding fx square, add everything. So you're supposed to add everything here. So you get summation of fx square, which is 3030. Okay, so that is for the continuous series. Now we have found out everything required to be added in the formula. Now let's go to the formula here. That is root of sigma fx square by n. It's the same formula for discrete series as well as continuous series. Root of sigma fx by n. So root of sigma fx square is 3030, which I have taken from here. And then 30, n is equal to 30 is taken from here. So when I divide 3030 by 30, I get square root of 101. And the total answer after taking the square root is 10.05. So this is the standard deviation for discrete as well as continuous series. Okay, hope everybody understood discrete as well as continuous series also. Do you have any doubt in this problem? Can you please leave that in chat if you have any doubt? Everybody understood? Okay, that is all for today's class. Thank you, students.